out. We'll take off, we'll go around the pattern once, make sure everything's good. And we're gonna head off to the north, kind of the northeast over by that ridge. See those two towers over there on top of the ridge?
Yeah.
We're gonna kind of head to those towers, and that'll take us to the paint mine.
Okay.
And then we'll fly around there for a few minutes, and then we come on back. Now the wind is blowing that direction, so we're gonna get there quicker, and then we're gonna have to fight the headwind coming back. So we want to make sure we're aware of how much longer it will take to get back, so we don't run out of time or gas. It's not that strong. The wind is actually dying down real nice. I mean, look at the windsock, barely moving now.
Yeah.
Probably a little stronger up top, but shouldn't have a problem. Yep, do our final checks. Seatbelts, chin straps, visors. Everything is inside the airplane. The GoPro is on recording. Altimeter is set. We got, you said 6 gallons of gas?
Yeah.
Okay. That's enough for about an hour and a half, so if we fly about an hour, we should be good. We should have a nice little reserve.
Okay.
No more than an hour because it'll be dark in an hour, so.
Yeah.
As long as we're back before dark, we got plenty of gas for that. I'm going to check the controls with the full range of motion, make sure everything is set. Alright. Alright, ISO. We're going to make our 360, and then we'll make our radio call
okay. To
traffic. And I want you to start listening to radio calls so you can start practicing with me, okay?
Okay.
And we have our rabbit sighted. Got to have our rabbit staged, ready to run and panic when we start taking off. It's like an unofficial rule out here.
Okay.
If you don't have a rabbit, you're not cleared for takeoff. Alright. Approach end looks good. Downwind looks good. Don't hear anything on the radio, so I think we're about ready. Okay, so here's how our radio call is going to go, guys. First off, we're going to say who we're calling, which is Springs East traffic, meaning traffic in the area of Springs East. Then we're going to say who we are. So we say Challenger and our end number, 443 Sierra Romeo. And then we say what we want to do. In this case, we are departing, getting ready to take off, and which runway we're using. Well, we're on runway 17 because this is the runway that faces 170 degrees. So you drop to zero and you get to say 17. And in this case, we're on the dirt on the left, not on the pavement on the right. So we'll say 17 left. And then we repeat it, Springs East, so everybody knows. If they were listening late, they go, okay, yeah, that's where it is. It's not at Meadow Lake or one of the other airports that's close by. Okay, so I'll say it for practice. You say it for practice, then I want to call it for real, okay?
Okay.
All right, so you go, Springs East traffic, Challenger 443 Sierra Romeo. Departing 17 left, Springs East.
Springs East traffic.
Who you're talking to? Who we are?
33 CR Romeo.
443 CR Romeo.
443 ECR Romeo. Who departing 17 left, Springs East traffic.
That's right. Okay, so you ready to go?
Yep.
Let's go. Springs East traffic, Challenger 443 Sierra Romeo, departing 17 left, Springs East. out. Video with him. We'll angle it back like that. smell right.
Smells like it's burning.
Yeah, it smells like rubber. Smells like tire, right? Let me check it out.
On back. This is not going to start itself, is it?
What's this? I saw the auto start.
Clear prop.
Thank you. Yeah.